Welcome to my channel. In this video, I will discuss peripheral arterial disease. So, peripheral arterial disease is just like the coronary artery disease, but in case of coronary artery disease, the symptoms are myocardial infarction or angina. In case of peripheral arterial disease, the symptoms depend upon the organ whose blood vessels are involved. For example, in case of blood vessels of brain, we can observe transient ischemic attacks. In case of limbs, we can observe intermittent claudication. So, peripheral arterial disease has the risk factors similar to that of the coronary artery disease, like smoking, obesity, hypertension, diabetes, and any hyperlipidemic and hypercoagulable states. So, pathogenesis is similar to coronary artery disease, that is presence of any atherosclerotic plaque or presence of any embolism that can lead to obstruction of the blood vessel and therefore ischemia of the organ that is supplied by that blood vessel. So, in case of limbs, we can observe intermittent claudication. What is intermittent claudication? Intermittent claudication is a condition in which we can feel ischemic pain in the legs after a certain degree of walk, and then when the person starts resting, then this pain disappears, but after he again starts walking, then the pain appears again. It is ischemic pain and it is called intermittent claudication. Then after more narrowing of the blood vessels, critical limb ischemia develops. What is critical limb ischemia? Critical limb ischemia is a condition in which the person feels pain at rest and are ulcerations and gangrene is present and it does not heal within 2 weeks. And the ankle blood pressure in this critical limb ischemia condition is less than 50 millimeters of Hg. And these are the patients that are mostly undergoing amputation of the legs. And these patients are also at the danger of death because of sepsis and other infective conditions. Furthermore, death can also occur in these patients due to MI. Why? Because the atherosclerotic conditions are also involving the coronary vasculature. So, acute limb ischemia can also develop in this condition patients. It is different from critical limb ischemia. How? Because critical limb ischemia mostly develops for longer time. That is, it takes a longer time to develop. But acute limb ischemia develops suddenly and it has certain features like pain, pulselessness, pallor, perishing cold, paralysis and paresthesias. These are denoted by P's. So acute limb ischemia is characterized by P's, that is pallor, pulselessness, perishing cold, paresthesias and paralysis. Furthermore, atheroembolism can also develop in these patients of peripheral arterial disease. This thromboembolism mostly affects the subclavian arteries and the persons present with the unilateral blueness of the fingers. That is, fingers in these patients are bluish in color, and this should not be confused with Raynaud's phenomenon, because Raynaud's phenomenon is a condition that affects both hands at the same time, while in this atheroembolism only single limb is involved in most of the cases. Furthermore, the peripheral arterial disease patients also develop subclavian steel. What is this subclavian steel? In these patients, when they move their limbs, due to movement of their limbs, there is steel of blood from the circulation of the brain to the limbs through the vertebral arteries, and the person feels anxiety, person collapses, and person also observes the cortical blindness. So this is all about the symptoms that a person can feel in peripheral arterial disease. So what is the management of this condition? So the risk factors should be identified, like if the person smokes, then he should stop smoking. If he is diabetic, then sugar or diabetes should be monitored, and then prompt treatment for diabetes should be done. Then he should be given antiplatelet therapy. Antiplatelet therapy includes aspirin and clopidogrel, but now a new drug is added also, that is protease inhibitor, that is protease receptor inhibitor, and therefore inhibits the platelet aggregation. This drug is vorapaxir, and vorapaxir is usually given in combination with aspirin and clopidogrel. If the patient does not relieve symptoms from these drugs, then we can give cyclosporine, that is a vasodilator. So if the person further feels symptom after 6 months of medical therapy, then we can give angioplasty or stenting, and we can also do bypass. But in case of subclavian peripheral arterial disease that is involving the subclavian artery, bypass is not done, but only stenting etc. can be done, because it is difficult to produce a carotid subclavian bypass. This is all about the peripheral arterial disease. Thank you for watching.